Hello, in this video I will talk on the Active Directory services and create a new user, Active Directory user. So here I open the Active Directory users and computers. So here we have some computer users, OU organizational units and so on. So here I will create a new and organizational unit, and let me name this org unit, let's say 2, okay, organizational unit 2, and then I say okay. And now here I will create a user. So I go back to I don't know if you can see this. So I open the Windows PowerShell ISE, and here I will name the user AD Active Directory user 2, and for the name I just say first 2, last 2, so so you can just put anything. Okay, first 2, last 2, so given name, surname, enabled, true, so you put this one dollar sign, true, and then path, organizational unit 2, and then this one, okay, example local domain controller, and office, just office 2, and then email address, title 2, department 2. So you can just put anything, but I just put department 2. And for the account password, you cannot just say, you cannot just put the password here, okay? It is not going to work because you need to encrypt it. And to encrypt it, this is the command that you use, convert to secure string, and then you put this your password in the double quotation as plain text, and then you say force, okay, and then it just forced it to encrypt and then assign it. And here I just run this. Okay, so it must be created. So let's go back to Active Directory users computers organizational unit. So let me just refresh it. Okay, perfect, it is right here. If I just double click on that, first name, last name, office, and email addresses, all of them here. And then member of domain users. Okay, and by automatically it's put in users. And there are some other profiles and account and so on. Example, and then AD user. And now let's create a group, Active Directory group. Okay, so here, you can create Active Directory group in the PowerShell as well, but I will just create it in here, new, and then group. And for the group, let me name it AD group 2, okay? And then not local, this should be global, and then security, and okay. All right, so we have a group. Now my goal is, so if I look at the members of this group, okay, run right click and then properties, and then if I look at the members, there is no member in this group. Okay, I just say cancel, and let me go back to PowerShell, and next one. So my goal is to put Active Directory user in this group. So this is the command. Add AD group member and identity. So this is the group, and actually you can put multiple members by separated by comma like this, but right now we just put AD user 2 in this group, and let me run it. Okay, it is run. So let me go back to here and let me just refresh it, and AD group 2, if I look at the properties, members, okay, right here. So we added this successfully, and this is all, and have a nice day.